Hi, my name is... Hi, my name is Brother Mitch, and I'm here today in Long Beach, California, in front of... in front of what's called the Queen Mary, the Queen Mary. Now, the Queen Mary was a ship that was donated to the American Allied Forces during the World War II. And it used to be a luxury ship. Luxury ship, you know, like the Titanic, beautiful chandelier, gold faucets, etc. Beautiful ship, carried about 2,500 passengers. Well, after it was given to the Allied forces, they stripped out all the chandeliers, removed all of the fancy silverware, and replaced it with military-style troop carrier. From over 2,000 passengers during its tourist season to sometimes 12, 13, 15, 16, and sometimes 20,000 military troops would be put on this ship behind me. Bunk beds sometimes. Six tiers high and aluminum trays replacing the nice fancy kitchenware. Well, why do I share all this? You know, some people have once said that it was the reason, if it wouldn't have been for the donation or the giving of this tourism ship to be converted to a troop carrier, World War II would have been quite more difficult to win. So this ship, we can say, added a great part in us winning the battle of World War II. Now, how do we relate this to missions? You know, the Bible says in Matthew chapter 28 and Mark chapter 16, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Some verses say go into all the world and make disciples of every nation. Well, there are what we call goers, those that go and preach, those that go and disciple. Now, not everybody can go, right? Not everybody can get on a plane and go into all the world and preach the gospel and make disciples. There's also what we call senders. A sender is someone that stays home and prays for the goers, stays home and sends money to the goers. They support goers. They support missionaries. They pray. They support. They even help mobilize others to be part in missions. Well, not only do we need great goers, but we need great senders. Now, like this man that donated his luxury ship to the war cause, we need people that are willing to really give all of their lives and everything that they have to the cause of missions. You know, in World War II was a literal war for the freedom of the nations. War, you know, against flesh and blood, but I'm talking about a war for tribes and tongues and peoples and nations of the earth. The Bible says it's not God's will that any should perish, but that all come to repentance. And so we're in a war for the souls of men, the hearts and souls of men. And we need everybody to be mobilized to give what they can. Like this man, he gave his ship. He couldn't go to war himself and fight himself. He couldn't. But he gave what he could. You know, and you can give what you can, whether it's your life, your life, your children. Billy Graham was once said, a famous evangelist, that one of the greatest hindrances to world evangelization is Christian parents who will not release their children into missions. That's a shame. So we need to all offer our bodies, offer our lives, not just even 10%, but everything. The Bible says to give generously, to give everything. Paul says to offer your body as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God. So you that are watching, Jesus wants everything. He wants all of your heart, all of your soul, all of your mind, all of your strength. He wants your kids. He wants your family. He wants your possessions. He wants your time. He wants all of your gifts, all of your abilities, everything to be laid on the altar for His cause, for His glory, for all nations and all tribes in all peoples and every tongue. You know, in the book of Revelations, it says, one day there will be people from every tribe, every tongue, every people, and every nation standing before the throne with palm branches in their hands, with white robes, singing, "Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb." And in order for us to see people from every tribe and every tongue before the throne, we need to go. We need to go into all the world, and we need to send goers into all the world. So you that are watching, continue to pray for us involved in missions, preaching the gospel, discipling the nations, and give as much as you can. Give as you're able. And as you give, of course, God will bless you. As we all work together, we can see the Great Commission finished in our generation. This is Brother Mitch signing off from Long Beach, California at Queen Mary. God bless you.